And welcome to Video Mojo. My name is John Leland and I'm a digital marketing strategist, and welcome. I'm so glad that you're here. Video Mojo is a playful exploration, and we're learning by doing. So it's a playful exploration of how to have a more vibrant video presence, or you could say a more vibrant and engaging social media presence using video. And it's been evolved, it has evolved from being a video blog into now being a web show, which is a combination of live streaming event like this, as well as a web video series, as well as a podcast. So if you're joining us in any of those recordings, welcome again, and I'm really happy that you're here. So here's the four-course meal that we're going to have today. So what happens is, in the four-course meal, we start out with what I call tee it up. And the tee it up is today is going to include two firsts, two things that have never happened before for Video Mojo, including a chance for you to win a $100 Amazon gift certificate. And I'll explain how to do that in just a second. The second thing is that I'm going to have a collaborative conversation with Shawn Shepheard. And the insights are about how to reimagine your business in these crazy times that we're living in. Both Shawn and I have found that our businesses have been reimagined and reinvented in the time of COVID, and we're going to talk about what's working in these new times. And then right after that, we're going to have your questions. We have live in this webcast format. If you're joining us live, you have the ability to comment either on Facebook or on YouTube, and we see those and bring them right up on the screen. And then finally, I always close with the dessert of luscious links. And I have two pretty cool social video apps for you today that I think are very powerful if you're looking to produce social video. So my tee it up today, as I said, has to do with two firsts. This web show environment that I just talked about, I've learned by experience and by experimentation, and if you've watched any of my other videos, I'm a big advocate of experimenting. And what's happened is that we've evolved into this web show, and for the very first time, I actually had a client come, a wonderful nonprofit called the Cancer Story Project, and we launched a web show for them. So that's something that's never happened before. Cancer Talks premiered last Tuesday. We'll put a link in the resource links for you if you want to check it out. But there's a new web show out there called Cancer Talks for the Cancer Story Project, and that's something that has evolved directly out of Video Mojo. And then the second thing is that we're doing this contest. Shawn Shepheard, the guest who will be with us in just a moment, came up with this brilliant idea, and we are going to give away a $100 Amazon gift certificate. And here's all you need to do. You take your cell phone, you turn with your back to the screen so that you can see that Video Mojo is on the screen. We want you to do it live during this webcast. So Shawn and I are going to get together today. So you need to do it live. We're going to get together at 1 o'clock Pacific, and we're going to look on Twitter, LinkedIn, and Instagram, and see who's hashtagged Video Mojo with a selfie watching live. And we don't have a huge audience, so you have a great chance if you do it. So please do it, and of course, we would love your support and all of that. And that's how you can win a $100 Amazon gift certificate. So now it's my pleasure to introduce Shawn. We love our collaborative conversations, and I've been just enjoying them to the max. And Shawn is an executive coach and a keynote speaker. He works with entrepreneurs and big global companies like LinkedIn, Verizon, Johnson & Johnson, Allstate, and Kraft Foods. I like his unique combination because he's a strategic thinker, he has raw honesty, and this robust sense of humor. So please welcome Shawn Shepheard. Welcome.
Thank you, John, and I'm thrilled to be on your live show, and with no delay. I don't know what you were thinking not putting me on a five-second delay, but thank you for the trust and the honesty.
Come on, you're not Patti Smith. I was watching a documentary about the groundbreaking radio station WBCN last night, and they were concerned about bleeping her out, and they did not, and neither are we going to bleep you out. Hey, this is web video. Anyway, Shawn, you've told me that your business took kind of a hit when COVID hit. When we started the pandemic back in February, March, tell me what your business was like then and what happened.
Yeah, so I went from the worst 2 months of the last 5 years to the best 2 months during a pandemic. And everybody knows what happened in March, and probably, I'm going to say probably 2 weeks after the shutdown here, I'm just outside of Toronto, Canada. I had all my in-person cancellations, all my in-person events were canceled for the entire year, including a dream keynote at Walt Disney World in front of 2,500 people, including trips to Boston, to San Diego, to Los Angeles to speak in companies, big global events. And to say that it was devastating was an understatement, John. It was devastating personally, professionally, to my income. And, I know we teach, hey, everything's a learning opportunity. In that moment, I was not like, hey, this is a learning opportunity. This was really devastating. And the quick thing that I'll say to transition was, I think, people like us and executive coach and people in coaching, we need to actually coach ourselves first. And that day that I found out that everything was canceled to the end of the year, I went downstairs and had lunch with my wife and, very Canadian lunch, a grilled cheese sandwich and tomato soup, and, talked to my wife and I asked for her help. I said, you know what? Me complaining about this and whining stops right here, right now. And I'm going to ask your help. If I start going down that path of complaining, isn't it awful? Call me out, because I need to work into switch to solution mode starting now.
Well, good for you. So how did you switch to solution mode? What was the answer to this problem?
Well, I don't know if you watch Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, but one of the options is call a friend. And I did. I called a very good friend and business colleague that I respect. And his advice was, Shawn, the next couple months are going to be challenging regardless of what you do. So his advice was to serve the clients and the people that you love, the people that you care about. Just serve them in only a way that you could do that. And it was great advice. And I got off the phone with him. And I sat down and took pen to paper, and I thought, okay, serve the clients that I love. So the first thing I did was write down my all-star team, the people that I love working with, and I think they love working with me. And I wrote them down and I identified that. So it was very, very intentional, very targeted. I have a rule, if we don't enjoy our company over a coffee or a beer, were probably not good. So number one was writing down those people that I really wanted to serve and show up for. And then number two
I'm going to interrupt you for 1 second there, because one of the things that I've really appreciated about our relationship and the things I've learned from you is this focus on who are your best customers, who are the people that, like you said, you'd enjoy sitting down and having a beer or a cup of tea with, whatever. And so that focus, I think, is really valuable just from a strategy point of view, COVID or no COVID, but it caused you to kind of double down on that focus of yours, yes?
Yeah, there's a saying, if you're for everybody, you're for nobody, right? And so, I'm not that clever, because it took me 20 years to figure this out. When you serve the people you're meant to serve and do your best work, that's a gift to both parties. So then I had that list. And then I thought, okay, what did my friend Chris say? And he said, serve those people and show up for those people today. And I was like, damn, I wish you could be a little more specific. Like, what does that mean? but then I thought, that's a good question. And I started to think about that. And I started to think about them individually as a group. Because there's not this one global answer, and you post something on LinkedIn and it solves all the world's problems. Every person has a unique situation. And so there's two things that I did. One was, I used to do an event in person called Socials with Shawn, and I'd bring my best clients and they could bring a guest and I give them a great event with some food and alcohol, but gave them a coaching experience. I thought, why don't I do that online? And so I went in on the Zoom and opened a Zoom account. I didn't even have a Zoom account. And I thought, well, let's just do this. It was a Friday afternoon. Planned it out, sent the invite out for Monday. Hey, why not? What's the worst that can happen? Nobody shows up. 14 people from across North America showed up. We had a blast. I gave them context and fun context on reimagining how they could apply this to their work tomorrow. They're going to be the smartest person in their virtual office tomorrow. And we had this connection because leaders feel like they're so lonely at the top. Who else do you talk to? So we brought them in the same room. At the end of that, there was no master plan. There was no master plan. At the end of that hour and a half, somebody said, when can we do this again? I was like, how about next Monday? Ended up doing that for 6 weeks straight. And that alone served so many of them in unique ways, gave them ideas that they can immediately implement the next day, and actually led to me doing those same sessions with their corporate teams. So that was one way.
Okay, and you want to do the second one? I mean, it has to do with the relationships in the breakout rooms, is that right? That,
yeah,
that people want to be connected, don't they?
People want to be connected, but my three-step process is I give them context of the conversation. So it would be leadership in challenging times, reimagining words, innovative thinking, whatever. So I give them context and teach. And then with that lens, that fresh context, they apply to their business situation. So it's not me telling them because I don't know. They can apply that context with fresh eyes to their business and then take action the next day. So that was kind of the three-step while having a lot of fun and maybe having a couple of drinks. So we did have breakout rooms where they were guided, facilitated breakout rooms where they had real conversations with other business leaders that they had a trust factor because I invited them into the room. If you were in the room, you were already, you know, somebody that I know, like, and trust. So I have a strong no, you know, jerk policy. So to be part of that community.
Very good idea.
It was awesome. No jerks. That's for other coaches. So then the second piece goes to you and video. So how could I identify? So I did a whole bunch of things publicly in LinkedIn and all of that sort of thing. But I took out this little camera, right? So no fancy equipment. My wonderful wife, her, you know, bless her right arm for shooting all these videos. And I shot over the course of the couple of months, I think 127 videos that were targeted to one person. So for example, John, if I was targeting you, I would do a selfie video or my wife would shoot it and say, hey John, I just wanted to say hi, send my love, I'm thinking of you. And you know, I know your team has been struggling with this one issue. Here's something that you could do today to lead a discussion. So I give them one nugget. For my clients in Boston, I would put on my Bruins jersey. I would call people out. And they were personal and they were unpolished and unscripted and people love them. They absolutely love them.
Yeah, I know. And I think that I want to pause. It's kind of like people sometimes speak and they go, think about it. And I want you to think about Shawn doing, you know, 100 plus videos targeted to specific people. And in my early video blogging, I talked about an app called BombBomb. But you know, which is designed for salespeople to do that kind of thing. But I loved how simply you did it. You just took your mobile phone, your smartphone, and you shot videos, again, one-offs, right? That's it's so simple, but why do you think that people don't do that more often? You know, it's like we have these incredible, you know, it's like the quality of camera. People don't realize that we have in these smartphones, particularly if you have anything relatively recent, are phenomenal and way better than most video cameras that we've had over the last 20 years. So we have this powerful tool in our pocket, But people aren't really taking advantage of it, particularly the idea of you can do something specifically, you know, for Bob, Mary, Sue, or whoever. Why do you think
I think that's a couple of things. I think people try to overcomplicate things. I always say, I'll give you the simple short answer, I can give you the long answer. So people try to overcomplicate things. Number two, money makes us dumb. When you have big budgets and you can spend on all these groups and agencies, that stalls the creativity and actually adds to your budget line.
Okay,
and bureaucracy.
Wait, I'm going to stop you there because that's like such a gem and such a like life experience for me that money makes us dumb. People think that you have to overproduce it. You need a director and a sound person and an art director and down the line, and you don't. And no. There's something that happens with the human personal connection that is invaluable. And you're now making videos for an audience of one. And did that help your business, Shawn?
Oh, my God. So the number one thing was I wanted to help that individual person because I actually care about the people that I work with. So if that made their day, if it gave them something that they could share with their team, that was amazing. And so many of them were like, Shawn, that made my day. Thank you. Nobody else is doing that. One of my major clients, a big international client, I sent the first one to her sales team, and she said, this was so amazing. Can I send this up through the executive management team? And so I'm like, sure. Like, it's this little selfie video. And I kept showing up. The key thing is show up. Keep showing up. So many companies and people during our time of need the last 7 months have gone missing in action. Show up and serve. And so that same client that, you know, John and I know we were talking about this yesterday, probably about a month, 3 or 4 weeks later, I got an email from one of the higher ups, which is usually really good or really bad. And he said, can we get on the phone? And basically he said, you know, Mr. Shepherd, we have a lot of high-priced consultants that have gone missing in action. We haven't heard from them since COVID started. And you just keep showing up every day. You just keep showing up and serving every day. Did I do it to help the bottom line immediately? No, but that led to probably 80% of the work that I'm doing now. Without leaving this room, I'm partnering with companies globally, presenting to teams in your home state in California, co-presenting with people in California. I'm presenting to all these other clients around the US that they didn't even know I existed 6 months ago without getting on a plane and while wearing soft pants. It's amazing what we can do when we ask ourselves what's possible now and really change our thinking.
Yeah, and this what's happened with video. You know, I was thinking, it's interesting, you mentioned those first 6 weeks when the pandemic broke out. I mean, part of what has moved me into this live webcasting is that I produced the first 6 weeks, a series for the Soul of Money Institute with Lynn Twist and Sarah Vetter. And we did, you know, Navigating Challenging Times as a 6-part webinar series. And people loved it. And so the video, it's clear that there's a new way to make relationships that was already happening. But COVID kind of accelerated it, and Zoom is the number one beneficiary from a big high-tech point of view. But so much personal video, like you're talking about, has now been empowered. So you and I can keep talking, and I'm happy to do that. But let me, you know, throw up my community campfire slide, and we want to open it to questions. So one of the cool things that happens as a result of the technology that we have here is that I can see your comments. If you're on Facebook, I can see your comments. If you're on YouTube, I can see your comments. And so we want to open it up to questions and see what's going on. I think that we have one, Vince Casalena, whoever that is. No, he's part of our team, has asked a question. He wants to know, did the personal videos come through the group Zoom meetings? I know the answer. It came through your smartphone, right?
Yeah, it came through there. But Vince, really good question, because every person that showed up in my Zoom meetings, I sent them a personal video of what to expect, like bring your drink, bring your pen and paper. I did all kinds of goofy things in them, and then I would send them a private video the next day, and people would go, why would you do 28 separate videos when you could shoot one? I had time, right? And is that a little bit more personal than to dear customer than dear John? So yeah, thank you. They kind of work simultaneously.
Good. All right. So we're open to more questions and comments. You know, you've also been doing what I think you call selfie videos on LinkedIn. What's that like? What's your strategy there, and how's that been working?
So anything that's the most personal. So I try to keep it short and one point. Again, not well, you know, they don't have to be overproduced. The thing that I'll say with LinkedIn, because that's the number one question I get, is how can I rock LinkedIn? Because I'm working with two clients that are rocking LinkedIn. I'll say this, if you're going to be on LinkedIn, that's my choice of where I hang out. You can pick whatever social media platform that suits you. If you're going to be on LinkedIn, be on LinkedIn. Don't outsource it to somebody else and be there every day. It's a conversation with others. And John, we've had great every week, John and I get on and we have this great conversation and connection. We haven't even met in person. That's the power of video, but I feel like
I don't think you've been talking about my home state of California. I should say you're in Toronto, Canada, yes. Just in case people don't know that.
But imagine, John, going to the LinkedIn of farming it out. Imagine, you know, we have a conversation. I end my week every Friday with John. It's the best way. I'm very, very lucky. So, but imagine today if I end my week with a conversation and Bob shows up and says, yeah, I'm actually, you know, I've been outsourced by John today to have all of his conversations today. We laugh because it's ridiculous, but people are doing that on social media. If you're going to be there, be there. They want to have a conversation with you. And you know, Scott Stratton, who's a big, you know, famous author and keynote speaker, if he can do it, anybody can do it. And if you don't want to do it and you don't want to put the effort in, then don't be there.
Yeah, I call it answering the social media phone. Well, our next comment off Facebook is actually a testimonial for you from Teresa Costa. She said that the socials with Shawn were great and that she loved the videos she received. So.
Teresa Costa is a big-time director at the YMCA in Toronto. So if somebody at her level loves them, thank you. And thanks, Teresa. Appreciate it.
Okay. And Laura McKenzie, also from your tribe, says that you've done full-on video webinars for her team. How do you keep people involved while online? What are some key insights to keeping people involved?
Thanks, Laura. And Laura is another, recently retired director. Two things. Have something worth saying, right? Don't bore them. But the most important thing, and I know I'm a big fan of Zoom, is the breakout rooms. Because they want to talk to each other under the context that I give them. When they can talk to each other and see each other, that's powerful. And in a me talking to the camera is a lot more challenging. But give them something worth sharing and that they can take an immediate action step to is another one. But thank you. Great questions. And I'm looking forward to your selfies.
Yeah, we want to see these selfies. Teresa says thank you, by the way. So this is more, I don't know, a practical matter of Jim Baldwin. He says he appreciates the encouragement to use the tool we have, the phone or whatever, as a superior to most equipment over the last 20 years. I feel, quote, empowered to do this. But I'm still trying to imagine how that would work for me. So Jim is a copywriter. So if you were talking to a copywriter and giving encouragement about how they might create personal videos, I mean, Jim, because I know that you're in Business Networking International, BNI, you do 45-second infomercials every week. Why aren't those on the web? I'll start there. But Shawn, you probably have ideas too.
Yeah, I was going to go, and thanks for the comment, Jim. I would say you think of your top three dream clients that you've worked with in the past and what's one or two challenges that they're facing right now and shoot a video on how you can help them right now. And full stop.
Beautiful. Last question, I think, is Teresa's back. What do you see on LinkedIn that drives you nuts? What's not a good way to connect on LinkedIn?
Okay, so do not ask to connect with me and then within 6 minutes sell me something and telling me what I need. Hey, Sean, I see you're a business coach and let's connect. And I'm like, okay, sure. And then the next one is like, here's my $1,000 program to get more sales and leads. And I'm like, I don't need any leads, thanks. Do not do that. The LinkedIn marketing is not about spamming people or, you know, it's one-on-one. The best example, and Perry Monaco, my buddy that works at LinkedIn, and full transparency, I have a relationship with LinkedIn. I've done a lot of work with them. They're fabulous. He says it's a cocktail party, or, you know, James, you're in BNI. You wouldn't spam everybody in BNI. You have one-on-one conversations, and it's the same thing on LinkedIn.
Exactly, yeah. And I think that as a last point here, I know that you work with a lot of companies around that LinkedIn marketing, and I totally agree with you. It's become spam to go, you know, friend somebody and then send them a request for business without any real relationship building. But you're quite masterful in terms of the relationship building on LinkedIn. Tell us more about that strategy and what's the right way to go about it. How do you really nurture relationships in an appropriate, authentic way on LinkedIn?
Thanks, John. I would say you nurture them the same way you do in real life, you know, by caring about other people, by being part of their conversation, by solving their problems, by not pushing your message. By, you know, there's some companies on LinkedIn, it's like, here's my product, here's my product, here's my product, here's my product. Yeah, well, how's that working? Would you like somebody to do that to you? So if you are the strategy, I work with smaller companies because they get it and they don't have the bureaucracy. But even if you work at a big company, the individual, because I have relationships with the people at the company, not the company. So then those individual people could use their network, because I want to have, you know, a good friend of mine who I think is watching is Sandy. They want to talk to Sandy or they want to have lunch with Sandy. They don't want to have lunch with the company. So then how can you serve those one-off people and be part of their conversation? And it takes effort. It's like anything. It's just like relationships in life, John. You know, it takes effort, right?
One conversation at a time, but not conversations with an agenda all the time. Yeah. Funny you mentioned Sandy because she, you know, I'm a big proponent of the tell them what you're going to tell them and tell them what you told them. Sandy posted a recap for us. 3 golden nuggets from this morning. Have a strong no jerk policy. Money makes us dumb. And show up and serve every day.
Thank you, Sandy. And I'll tell you, Sandy is a hero in the diabetes community across North America and super, super creative. And, you know, I look at the stuff that she has done and done with very little budget or no budget. Absolutely. And I'm applauding you. And thank you for showing up. I appreciate it.
Yeah, me too. And Sean, I appreciate you showing up. I really appreciate the time and I love our friendship and you're a real gem. You bring real quality to what you do and I love the energy and the humor. So thanks for making the time today and thanks for being my pal and thanks for the inspiration about the contest. And I think we're going to have to do this again, don't you?
I would love it. I told Lorne Michael I can't do Saturday Night Live tomorrow because I'm doing John's live show today. Anytime, my friend. I love what you're doing. I love how you show up in the world. Anytime, the answer is going to be yes.
Thank you so much. So we'll see you again very soon. And we're going to move on. So I love doing Luscious Links as part of the show, kind of like I called it the dessert earlier. And there, I have actually three empowering tools for doing social video. And the first one is canva.com, which we use all the time. And in fact, we're going to be doing some short segments with some of the segments out of Video Mojo. So watch for them on YouTube and the other social networks. But what I want to show you also today is a couple of really powerful new tools that I'm looking to experiment with. So the first one is this, it's called Veed.io, and it's quite impressive in terms of the tools and ease of use. It's really designed for social media. One of the things that I've wanted to add to short videos is a time countdown like that, and that's built into the platform. You can add text, you can create all kinds, it'll transcribe for you. Really, really a very robust feature set. They do have a free platform, so that makes it easy to use. And I definitely think this is a powerful tool worth exploring, especially if you, you know, are looking for something that you can start out with for free. A more powerful tool that I really think is worth exploring is promo.com. And promo is, it definitely costs, it starts around $39 a month on an annualized basis, but they have just a ton of templates. In fact, you could even look towards just for Halloween, there are a whole bunch of templates. So as in terms of cranking out videos that really have an interesting message, it's really powerful. And one of the things I like about it is that you can take the same template and make it vertical for Instagram stories or Facebook stories or for TikTok. And you can also do it square for the Instagram theme and also do it horizontal, same template pre-built for you. So you can obviously customize these with your own video. You can also, I mean, one of the things I was going to show you, if I customize it, there's a whole bunch of different text treatments, for example. So you can replace the video with your own video, but down the right side here is a whole bunch of other text treatments where you can customize it and make it your own and obviously build in your own message. So those are my luscious links for today. And that's, I think both of those will help you upgrade your social media presence. So, in closing, let me just say one more time, you still have a chance between now and 1 p.m. Pacific to post your selfie with Video Mojo Live in the background. Post it to either Instagram, LinkedIn, or Twitter with the hashtag Video Mojo. And Shawn and I, thank you, Shawn, for being my partner in this contest, are going to provide an Amazon gift certificate to the most creative, fun one. We're going to meet at 1 p.m. Pacific today and look on those three networks and pick a winner, and I'll announce the winner in next week's Video Mojo. So speaking of next week's Video Mojo, Jay Acunzo is a great content marketer, not only because of his Google and ESPN background, but he's the founder of Marketing Showrunners, a big advocate for web shows like this and podcasts in particular. He has a whole podcast where he critiques podcasts. So we're going to talk about the ins and outs of this format of creating a web show as a way to be more present, engaging, and vibrant on video and social media. And then the next Friday, again, always at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern, I'm going to do what I'm calling the web show, where I'm literally going to take my camera, turn it around at my screen, and show you the ECAMM Live software that I'm using and all the razz and jazz that's making this happen. So that's Video Mojo for today. It was fun, and I'm really glad that you were here. Thank you for everybody who participated with the comments and questions. If you're looking for more ways to connect or you want to subscribe to our email newsletter, link up to the blog where we have all the past episodes of Video Mojo, play.combridges.com/links is a page with a whole bunch of links like that. So you are the ones that make this happen. I'm here for you, and I look forward to your questions and comments. I know time is precious, so the fact that you watch really means a lot to me. And I look forward to seeing you next week on another edition of Video Mojo. Until then, bye-bye.